Hello everyone, and welcome back to Detroit Become Human. We are going to talk to this girl. Actually, no, I think we're talking to the dad. Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm playing.
I know what you're thinking. You think your dad's a lowlife?
Yeah, I do.
Huh? Fucking loser?
Yep.
Can't get a job, take care of his family? Don't you think I tried to make things work? But whatever I do, when someone comes along, they just fuck it all up! I know what you think of me. You hate me. You hate me, don't you? Say it! You hate me!
I hate him. I'll admit that.
God, what am I doing? I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You know I love you, don't you? You know I love you.
Let's go, let's follow the chain. A new home. Public opinion skeptical, Alice trusted. What does the public opinion mean then? I don't know. Welcome home. Join Todd. Read Android Power. Wash the dishes, talk with Alice. There was one thing I didn't unlock. A bunch of things I didn't unlock for cleaning the first floor. Take out the trash, ask to go upstairs. Go upstairs. Clean Todd's room, tidy pills. Cara sees gun? Where was the gun? I don't remember seeing that. I must have been talking over it. Cara discovers a way down. Oh, good. Okay, good. Talk with Alice. Alice gives Cara a key. Open Alice's box. Finished cleaning. So we have an escape route now. The stairs are cool, I like them. They haven't taught me how to walk faster, so I assume this is the fastest I can walk. Which kind of makes sense, I suppose. Ooh. That is just extravagant, like, that's completely unnecessary. That is an insane display of wealth that they can just have that in their home. And the giraffe, like, I didn't really think rich people cared about art that much. Well, I guess they kind of do, because at least in the media they're always going to art galleries and stuff, but I don't know, I think they care more about money than art, to be honest. And I'm not going to sit here and pretend like I don't care about money, but I don't know, art doesn't have much like value to insanely rich people. I guess it does, I don't know. And they can sell it, and they're always bidding on it in auctions on TV and stuff, so I don't know. Oh. Okay, I'm calling it. He's gonna die. We're gonna take his money
and
go somewhere.
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
It's 10 a.m. The weather is partly cloudy, 54 degrees. 80% humidity with a strong possibility of afternoon showers.
I wonder if his name is a reference to Up.
It sounds like a good day to spend in bed.
I think the dude in that's called Carl, right?
I did go to pick up the paint that you ordered.
Oh, yes, I've forgotten. That is the difference between you and me, right, Marcus? You never forget anything.
Show me your arm, please.
Oh, we might have the choice to kill him.
Carl. Thank you.
I just opened my eyes and I'm already gritting my teeth. Humans are such a fragile machine. They break down so quickly. All this effort to keep them going.
Okay. I'll take you to the bathroom now.
Ship it. I just can't look at that in like a non-romantic way, like, I don't know.
Anything special on the agenda today?
Yes, there's the opening of your retrospective at the Museum of Modern Art. Mm. The gallery director left 4 messages asking to confirm your attendance.
I haven't decided yet. We'll see about that later.
Okay.
What else?
Just your usual fan mail. I've already answered.
Any news from Leo?
No, Carl. I can call him if you like.
No. No, don't bother.
Is he gay? Oh, maybe that's his son.
I'm starving.
Well, your breakfast is ready. Bacon and eggs, just the way you like them.
Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
I kind of like this guy. I thought he was going to be a pretentious... rich asshole, but I like him. We probably are going to have the choice to kill him, and it'll be like this tough moral thing. I don't know. Like, we can choose to take his money and run and give him an overdose or not, but if that is an option, then I'm not going to, because I quite like him. Where is the kitchen? Not out of the room, I guess. Here we go. Maybe we'll find him and he'll be dead. Maybe he'll kill himself. You may have noticed I like to guess the plot twists so that if they're correct, then I can take credit for them and look really smart.
Thank you, Marcus. Television.
So I've heard somewhere, I don't know if this news report is important or not, it doesn't seem like it.
Why don't you find something to do while I finish my breakfast?
Sure. Okay, Carl.
I've heard that Marcus refers to Carl as his master, and considering the racial implications, I just find that a little uncomfortable. Oh, let's play piano. Oh wait, there are other, damn, there might be other things I could have done. We could go intimate and try and like, meh. I was gonna say like earlier when we were carrying him, we could try and woo him. They're really going to make me do this one key at a time. Seemingly so. Oh, I see, okay. Stop in a minute. Imagine if I played really badly.
Something has changed in the way you play.
You've gotten shitter.
Sometimes I think you have more humanity than most humans.
You know what? I like this dude.
One day I won't be here to take care of you anymore. You'll have to protect yourself and make your choices. Decide who you are and want to become. This world doesn't like those who are different, Marcus.
Fuck.
Don't let anyone tell you who you should
this
be.
This old man is awake.
Let's go to the studio.
Is this going to make me cry? I hope not. I really don't want to cry.
Let's see where we left off.
Especially at a quantum.
Remove the sheet.
Any cleaning I can do, or that's a bit weird. Should I be concerned about that? Come on, he's caught on the corner. Is that all the cleaning? No. Still, if this is the fastest I can walk, it seems like it might get annoying. I'm usually the one to walk slow in games though, because of realism, but I like to have the option to move faster.
So, what's your verdict, Marcus?
Yes, there is something about it. Something I can't quite define. I guess I like it.
The truth is, I have nothing left to say anymore. Each day that goes by brings me closer to the end. I'm just an old man clinging to his brushes.
Carl.
But enough about me. Let's see if you have any talent. Give it a try. Try painting something.
All right.
Paint? What would I... Painting what?
Anything you want. Give it a try.
There's an app game I play called Choices Stories You Play, and one of the games in it is about like a dating service that matches you up with a spoiler, I guess. It matches you up with your perfect match, but it's an android and you don't know. And in the last chapter, they just kind of had they asked the AI girl to look at a painting and tell them what she thought about it, and she couldn't feel anything, and that's how they justified that she doesn't feel or whatever, because she looked at the painting and she felt nothing. Let's paint the statue. I completely butchered that explanation. I would love if it's just like a stick drawing and it's terrible. But I guess people like Bob Ross and... Is it Mr. Rogers? Is that his name? I think that might be someone else. I don't know. But there's another guy who does it as well, who...
That is a perfect
just
copy.
Tells you to paint whatever you like, even if it's shit.
Of reality. The painting is not about replicating the world. It's about interpreting, improving on it, showing something you see.
Carl, I don't think I can do that. It's not in my program.
Go on, go. Try it. Grab that canvas. Do something for me. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Trust me.
His hesitation kind of made it seem like he was disobeying.
Try to imagine something that doesn't exist, something you've never seen.
You literally can't.
Now concentrate on how it makes you feel. And let your hand drift across the canvas.
He paints dick butt. What's the deepest? What's the deepest, most pretentious I can pick? Let's go with humanity. Empathy.
God.
This guy's gonna kill his dad. He's gonna kill Carl.
Hey, Dad.
Leo. I didn't hear you come in.
I was in the neighborhood. I thought I'd stop by. It's been a while, right?
You all right? You don't look so good.
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. Hey, listen, I need some cash, Dad.
Again? What happened to the money I just gave you?
It just goes, you know?
Yeah, you're on it again, aren't you?
No, I swear, it's not that.
Don't lie to me, Leo.
What difference does it make? I just need some cash, that's all.
Sorry. The answer's no.
What? Why?
You know why.
Yeah, I think I do know why. You'd rather take care of your plastic toy here than your own son, right? Tell me, Dad, what's it got that I don't? Smarter? More obedient? Not like me, right? But you know what? This thing is not your son. It's a fucking machine!
Leo, that's enough. Enough.
You don't care about anything except yourself and your goddamn paintings. You've never loved anyone. You never loved me, Dad. You never loved me.
That's reasonable and all, but dude, you're like a drug addict. I mean, there's nothing like... Oh, okay. I'd better clarify. Obviously, being a drug addict isn't a good thing, but I'm not trying to judge him for being a drug addict. Just that, like... he's the one who's come barging in, asking for money, and he's the one being a threat in this situation, you know. He's the one starting this shit. So, he's in the wrong here, is what I meant. I meant that he's just asking for money because he's addicted to drugs, like, you know. Or something, maybe alcohol, but I think drugs. Alright, arriving home, drop off package, wait Carl, serve breakfast, find something to do. We played the piano, there were other things I could have done though. Take Carl to the studio. So far the replay value doesn't seem insane. Like, there are all these branching options and everything, but none of them seem like the kind of thing that would make you play the game again. Like, I'm not going to play the game again just to paint a different painting, you know? Like, it's cool there's so many branching paths, but it's not something I'm going to replay the game just to do, just to paint like an angry painting about androids. I really like this game so far, actually. I was prepared to, like, be tearing the shit out of it and just hating it and making fun of it the whole time, but I really like it. Oh no. Last time there was a bar in a Quantic Dream game, the main character almost got raped. Jimmy Peterson, criminal record, none, business owner.
Shit, I thought androids were...
Hold on, wasn't done. Can we check this guy? No.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. Just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I must insist. My instructions stipulate that I have to accompany you.
You know where you can stick your instructions?
No. Where?
Never mind.
Oh,
I apologize, Dan. Lieutenant. I didn't mean to bother you.
I'm too indecisive.
I'll wait for you outside. Take your time.
Did you say homicide?
I hope their characters are a little different to Blake and,
My instructions are to accompany you to the crime scene, Lieutenant.
Listen, I don't give a fuck about your instructions.
And Jaden.
I told you to wait here, so you shut the fuck up and you wait here.
Douglas for Channel 16.
So far it seems like they're the same archetype.
I'm not confirming anything.
As Jaden and Blake in the last game in Heavy Rain. And I hope they're a little different.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
The cop with like
you don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8 from the landlord. The tenant hadn't paid his rent for a few months, so he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on.
Where are the stairs? I was assuming
it was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
Well, state he's in. Wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside. All the windows were boarded up. The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
One thing I noticed is that it seems like they sourced all their actors from America for this game. In their previous games, they kind of had people who very obviously weren't American doing American accents that weren't completely convincing. But with this game, they've hired people. I mean, it's fine to have an accented character. If they're not supposed to be from that place, you know, but when they're supposed to be American.
Is this written in the victim's blood?
French.
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
You know.
Oh, Jesus, what the hell are you doing?
You don't have to taste.
I'm analyzing the blood. I can check samples in real time. I'm sorry. I should have warned you.
Okay, just don't put any more evidence in your mouth. You got it?
Got it.
Fucking hell, I can't believe this shit. Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked to party. Chris, I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Consider it done, Lieutenant.
It's good to be thorough.
Mike, you finished taking samples there?
Yeah, that's it.
So it had something to do with the android probably rebelling, maybe? Or maybe they had a disagreement about whether the android was like alive and a human being or not. And so the android killed this guy. Database match, Carlos Ortiz, criminal record theft and aggravated assault. Well, he deserved it then. I mean, it depends, I guess. Victim fell here.
Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for him.
Six more things to find. I probably will go for all of them. If I really can't find something, I probably will just give up. But I want to find everything if I can. Please don't let him have OCD or something. I feel like the portrayal of that would be very good. Okay, it's a weird religious thing. I guess that's fine. Did you see that? Hang on, I'll get back. It said, sorry ladies, but plastic can't be beat. I really feel like that could be the future, to be honest. Not that I think all women are going to be replaced with sex androids or anything, but I feel like they'll be more common. Not more common than women, but like, they'll be more common than they are now. A lot of people will choose to have androids instead because they don't have limitations or anything. At least if you believe that they don't feel or have emotions or anything. If you only care about them as an object, then they don't have boundaries or anything, so you can do what you want with them. And that's not me saying that in a good way, that's me saying that a lot of people probably only want like a sex object instead of a person with the ability to consent and stuff, you know. I'm laughing because this conversation is, well, I was gonna say too serious, but we're at a crime scene, so I guess it's not too serious because that guy's been killed. What else is there? There's probably a room I'm missing. probably would have been bad if I'd missed that. Oops. I support the android in this situation. I think it was justified. Okay, I think it might annoy me if I don't get that 10th thing, so...
Door was locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time.
Part here, because we've been going for a little while. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see